I'm Matt Sampson. Thanks for joining us on Daytime in these tough economic times. Finding and actually landing a job can be a real challenge, but there are some things you can do to set yourself apart. Joining us now is Westchester, author of this book, The Image of Success, Make a Great Impression and Land That Job You Want. She's Lizandra Vega. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you for having me.
These are some good points to start with there, and there are a couple points that I'm interested in hearing you explain them, but let's start with the basics. You're saying, really, you've got to present yourself well.
Absolutely. And I love to talk about appearance, because in my book, I go through the ABCs of finding a job. So the A is for appearance, and I really stress the suit, because in this weather where it's getting scorchingly hot, and sometimes candidates feel they're going to a creative environment and they don't need to wear a suit, well, it's a requirement. It's not optional.
Okay, good point. And you're saying the other thing which I think people have overlooked, growing up it was always a big thing when I was a kid, you got to have a good handshake.
Oh,
and you're
yeah.
saying don't forget that.
Don't forget that. It's absolutely. The handshake is so important. And also the way you give the handshake. Just a nice web-to-web handshake with a medium to firm grip.
Okay.
And you pump three times. One, two, three. It takes about 5 seconds. You don't cup the person's hand, sandwich the person's hand, or give a dead
a
fish
little one
or
of those
one of these,
or something.
Like where you
yeah.
just give your finger. There are so many of them out there, and I really caution candidates about it.
And one of the things, this is what I'm really interested in, and I got to watch myself now here, because she was talking about beware of and be aware of all your innocent gestures.
That's
what
right.
do you mean by that?
Innocent gestures, like winking. Sometimes people tend to say something and then they underline it with a wink, or they lick their lips, or they play with their fingers with their rings back and forth, or they toss their hair, and it's a little sexual, a little provocative. So I warn candidates about that.
Ooh, that's interesting stuff. Also, you talk about netiquette. You know, if you walk in with a BlackBerry cell phone or whatever, you're saying you got to be sure about this.
Absolutely, and make sure you turn it off, because there's so many distractions, and you don't want to create your own distractions. You don't want to bring your own distractions with you.
And a very, very good point that you make. You talk about sending a thank you note.
Sending the thank you note is not old-fashioned, and it should be done within 24 hours, because if you send it a week or two later, the job has been filled.
Let's talk about, should it be a handwritten thank you note mailed, or do we just type something up and send an email?
Well, I think to get your point across, you can send something emailed, but I think you should follow it up with a handwritten note as well.
Now, is there anything else with netiquette I should know about? If you have to communicate with this person, prospective boss via email, are there things I should watch out for there?
Well, I think that things like emoticons and little happy faces and little signals that you might send to a friend are not necessarily appropriate when you are sending an email to a prospective employer.
And I know you have a book signing coming up, because there's a whole book about this and a lot of detail to go into. A lot of it, you know, the email generation, electronic generation, I'm a little behind on myself, so I'm interested. You're having your book signing at Holbrook Cottage in Briarcliff Manor. That's Saturday from 1 to 3 p.m., so folks, you can get out there and talk to Lizandra about that. And if you can't make it, of course, go to our website, news12.com. We'll link you over, and you can find out a lot of stuff. One more tip before I go.
One more tip.
Anything about my hair, especially man or woman?
Well, I really love the red tie. It's a red power tie. So, and it's very authoritative, and it also blends with the theme of my book.
Okay, very good. Thanks very much. And stay with us, folks. We'll have much more coming up, but we want to see the book one more time. There it is, The Image of Success, and it's subtitled, Lizandra, tell me.
Make a great impression and land the job you want.
I like the sound of that. Stay with us, folks. Much more ahead on Daytime.